Llama 4 is lost. Meta AI released Llama 4 Scout and Llama 4 Maverick on a Saturday, 2 days ahead of their own schedule. And at first it made headlines for being number 2 on the LMArena leaderboard until people read the fine print and realized that it was an experimental version of Maverick that was optimized to score highly on LMArena. And the chart that they used didn't even include Gemini 2.5 Pro, which outperforms Maverick. Now, a year ago when Llama 3 launched in April of 2024, it was seen as the open standard. But things have devolved quite a bit at Meta AI since then, with multiple high-level employees leaving the company, including their head of AI research, Joelle Pineau. What's more, the state of open-source AI changed significantly when DeepSeek released V3 in December of 2024 and then R1 in January of 2025, and so Llama 4 has left a lot of people feeling disappointed. It's worse at coding than V3 and R1, as well as Alibaba's Qwen 2.5 Max and Qwen QWQ, but in spite of this shortcoming, Llama 4's license is actually more restrictive than these Chinese models. DeepSeek's models are published under an extremely open MIT license, and Qwen's are under Apache 2.0, whereas with Llama 4, any product or service that uses Llama 4 at runtime needs to mention that it was built with Llama. And if you build an actual AI model with Llama, then you need to put Llama at the beginning of the model's name. You also can't use Llama 4 models if you have more than 700 million monthly active users, which admittedly isn't going to be a problem for 99.9% of the companies that use Llama 4, but it didn't stop Sam Altman from calling them out because OpenAI is working on an actual open model too, their first since GPT-2, and according to Sam, it won't have the kinds of restrictions that Llama's models do.